Now, the deadline set by the International Criminal Court in The Hague for the Libyan authorities to answer questions on the health and status of Saif al-Islam, the son of Colonel Gaddafi, the former leader of Libya, expires this week. Libya's already asked for an extension to the deadline. The ICC has indicted him for crimes against humanity. But Libya's new leaders say they want him to stand trial in Libya. Nabila Ramdani is a journalist who's interviewed Saif al-Islam in the past. Tell us what will happen this week, do you think, Nabila?
Well, this week, the new Libyan rulers are faced with a second deadline as they must tell the International Criminal Court's judges what plans they have for holding a trial for Saif al-Islam Gaddafi. Essentially, they will have to prove that they are not only willing, but indeed able to guarantee a free trial to Saif al-Islam Gaddafi that would satisfy the international community. And if the International Criminal Court judges deem conditions in Libya not suitable, then they can still rule their wish to hear the case themselves at The Hague.
Where is he at the moment, and does anyone know how he is?
Since being arrested by the Zintan militia in November last year, he's been held in a makeshift prison cell in Zintan, which is a town 100 miles southeast of Libya's capital, Tripoli. He's closely guarded, he's denied visitors, television, radio and the internet, but more crucially, the new Libyan rulers have failed to tell him what he's charged with or give him access to a lawyer, which has prompted a torrent of criticism from international human groups.
Tell us, what's your feeling? How will this play out, do you think?
Libya is still very much a volatile country at the moment, and human rights groups say the National Transitional Council is far from having a credible judicial system. So in my opinion, confrontation with the ICC is now looming, and it will be technically difficult for the ICC to extradite Saif Gaddafi should the conditions for him to face a fair trial not be met.
Right.
Now, should Libya go ahead with a trial unsanctioned by the ICC and without international participation, it will pose a problem for both the UK and France, who backed the rebels with NATO airstrikes, but also with illegal means such as special forces arming and training the rebels and providing financial support.
Right.
And for the Libyans, it will also be a test for the new regime's commitment to justice.
And Nabila Ramdani, thank you very much for your time. Thank you.